Hi, I share with you my presentation during the 27th International Conference on Image Processing held in Abu Dhabi from 25 to 28 October 2020. Our paper is entitled Depth Maps Fast Scalable Compression Based on Coding Unit Depth.
Hello, I am Dursaf Sabai, Assistant Professor at INSAT and image processing researcher at Crystal Laboratory at Annecy. I will present our work entitled Depth Maps Fast Scalable Compression Based on Coding Unit Depth, that is realized by my fellows Sonia Masbeh and Professor Fawzi Ghorbel and myself. The plan of the presentation is as follows. I will first introduce the context of our work. Second, I will detail the proposed CU partitioning method. Third, I will present the results and discussions. Finally, the conclusion and perspectives will be drawn. Three-dimensional videos include important scene information for innovative applications such as 3D television that allows the viewer to perceive the depth of the scene thanks to multi-view stereoscopic and auto-stereoscopic display systems, and 3 viewpoint television that provides the ability for users to interactively navigate and select a viewpoint in the video scene. Multi-view video plus depth NVD is the most appropriate representation of 3D videos that can support the 3D TV and more specifically the FTV requirements. NVD is a 3D representation that gathers both actual image sequences and depth maps captured by N cameras. Depth maps are two-dimensional grayscale images of the same size as the texture images they are associated with. The grayscale level of each pixel of the depth map indicates the distance of the camera to the camera of its corresponding texture pixel. Being different from texture images, depth maps are distinguished by two intrinsic features, namely their piecewise planar definition. In fact, each plan corresponds to an object of the scene, where intensity of its coplanar pixels varies in a linear way. Each contour placed at the edges of text reproduces a sharp discontinuity between objects in foreground and background. The second feature is the impact of depth discontinuities on the quality of the synthesized views. It's not the case for smooth regions. The distortion of compression errors in these regions have a considerably less noticeable or even limited effect on synthesized views. However, the compression errors of the contour pixels and those near them result in a highly visible degradation of the synthesized views. Therefore, the preservation of the depth discontinuities is crucial. The reception of the NVD on a variety of display devices from a variety of types of transmission networks brings to light the need to progressive or scalable compression. Scalability provides different versions of the same signal, starting from a coarse quality to achieve a refined one. Unlike multicast compression, scalability enables the encoding of an image or a video once in multiple layers, which makes it more efficient in terms of network capacity utilization. Being an extension of HEVC, SHVC, scalable high-efficiency video coding, is the latest standard enabling the scalable compression. The SHVC architecture design is composed of one base layer, BL, the lowest quality representation, and multiple enhancement layers, ELs, that, as their name indicates, provide better versions of the encoded signal. Each EL is coded by referencing lower layers thanks to the SHVC interlayer prediction, ILP. SHVC supports several scalability types, namely spatial signal-to-noise ratio, SNR, temporal, chiral gamut, bit depth, and hybrid codec. For the particular SNR scalability subject of this paper, layers are of the same spatial resolution. The quality is improved by reducing the quantization parameter QP values. The higher QP is assigned to DBL, while the lower ones are assigned to ELs. Delta QP is the difference between these QP values. Being based On HEVC, SHVC uses the same partitioning of the image to encode in a particular quadtree structure. The image is first partitioned into CTUs, coding 3 units. Then, each CTU is recursively partitioned into 4 equal sub-CUs till a maximum depth of 4 levels. Depth 0 corresponds to the largest CU of size 64 by 64. Depth 1, the CU is of size 32 by 32. Depth 2, the CU is of size 16 by 16. And 3, the CU is of size 8 by 8. It corresponds to the smallest CU. For each depth, the current CU is partitioned into 4 sub-CUs using a rate distortion optimization, RDO, decision function. This latter aims to decide whether the current CU has to be divided or not. SHVC is proven to decrease bandwidth requirements by up to 46.41% compared to its predecessor SVC, Scalable Video Coding Standard, for the same video quality. However, SHVC is highly computational and suffers from large complexity because of the image partitioning to coding units using the rate distortion optimization decision function and the ILP, the interlayer prediction process, which requires improvements to ensure the practical usability of SHVC standard. For a given input depth map, the main sites and steps of the proposed method are as follows. Side 1 is the BL construction. The BL is generated in the same way as already done in SHVC. We preserve the conventional and usual steps, namely the depth maps partitioning into CTUs, CTUs partitioning into CUs, HEVC prediction mode selection, quantization, and entropy encoding. Site 2 is the ELS construction. Step 1 is the contour detection of the input depth map. Step 2 is partitioning of the obtained depth map in CTUs. Step 3 is partitioning of the CTUs into CUs. For each CU, we check if it contains contours or not. If no, the CU is not partitioned and it inherits the CU depth of its collocated CU in BL. Hence, the depth of the CU in EL is equal to BL collocated CU depth. If yes, if the CU contains contours, the CU partitioning is redone without considering the CU depth reached in BL. In fact, sharp depth discontinuities must be preserved since they have a much more impact on quality of synthesized views than smooth regions. The last step consists of the conventional HEVC prediction mode selection, quantization, and entropy encoding. To assess the efficiency of the proposed method, we implement it on SHVC test model, SHM version 12. For this, we make use of 9 test video sequences that are heterogeneous and of different depth variations. For each sequence, 100 frames are encoded using the unmodified SHVC and our proposed method. Typically, we generate 2 layers respectively encoded at QP values of 26, 30, 34, 38 for BL and 22, 26, 30, 34 for EL. For the detection of the depth map's contours, we opt for 2 detection thresholds, which are equal to 1 and 4. The proposed method performance is evaluated in terms of computational complexity. Here, the time improving ratio, peer measurement expressed in percentage, is adopted. The peer is evaluated for the different test sequences. Using the 2 edge detection thresholds, percentage of smooth and contour regions are also provided for each test sequence. Based on the obtained results, the encoding time of the proposed method is in average 51.45% faster than the unmodified SHVC for edge detection threshold of 1. For threshold 4, it's almost 70% faster since a higher threshold leads to lesser edge regions and so to less CUs to reconstruct in EL. If the depth map includes more contour regions than smooth ones, the obtained tier is smaller than tier reached for depth maps of more smooth regions than contour ones. In fact, this latter include larger number of smooth CUs that will not be repartitioned in EL and for which the depth will be inherited from their collocated in BL. In order to check the impact of our method on the view synthesized from the encoded depth maps, we present rate distortion curves, RD curves. These latter depict the performance of the proposed method and a modified SHVC in terms of bit rate expressed in kilobit per second and PSNR expressed in decibel for the synthesized views of the different test sequences at contour detection threshold 1. Bjorn-Tegard metrics corresponding to these curves are presented in this table. Compared to a modified SHVC, our method slightly decreases the quality of the synthesized views. This can be explained by the fact that the partitioning of only contour CUs that highly impact synthesis quality is redone in EL. By means of this, we gain in terms of execution time without actually causing degradation of synthesized views quality. The same results are also presented for the second value of threshold, which is equal to 4. A slight decrease is also depicted here. This paper presents fast scalable compression for depth maps. The proposed method aims to optimize the CU's partitioning in EL according to their content. If they correspond to smooth regions, they maintain the same collocated CU structure already obtained in BL. Otherwise, the CU partitioning process is repeated in the EL. On the one hand, this can preserve the sharp depth discontinuity that are important to synthesize intermediate views of good quality. On the other hand, it allows us to speed up the encoding process of SHVC. Obtained results show that our method reduces the SHVC encoding time by more than half at the cost of a minimal PSNR loss. Aside from reducing the execution time of SHVC, we aim as future work to improve the synthesized views quality, particularly that SHVC is not originally dedicated to depth maps encoding. Thank you for your attention. I remain at your disposal for any question, remark, comment, or discussion. And thank you again.